Welcome to Power of Change Christian Church Sunday Morning Celebration. Good morning and welcome to Power of Change Christian Church Sunday Morning Celebration Pre-Show. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
I am your host, Mia Turner, and joining me this morning is...
Latia Humphrey.
Latia. Good morning. How's it going?
It's going good.
It's a beautiful morning. The weather is amazing.
Amazing. It feels good out there.
I know. And it's going to get actually hot today. Can you imagine?
I think it's at like 81.
And I had my heater on to like two
Ooh.
Nights ago.
Oh, no. Turn it off.
Well, it was cold at night. But this bipolar weather we have is so awesome. Well,
yes.
We are here to welcome you to our pre-show because in just about 14 minutes, our Sunday morning celebration will begin here at Power of Change. We are so excited and we're so happy you have joined us. You have so many options out there on a Sunday morning to stream any kind of service that's out there, but you chose to be with us. And if you happen to look upon us this morning and never seen us, God made sure you found us today. So we are thankful and grateful and want to remind you to like, comment, and share. Share this gospel message with everyone you know. So we want to get started with the scripture. Latia has it for us.
Yes, I do, y'all. So today we are celebrating International Sunday.
International Sunday.
We're in our native tribe.
And forever.
So today's scripture is coming from Psalms 86 and 9. All the nations you have made shall come and worship before you, O Lord, and shall glorify your name. Hallelujah.
Glorify your name. All the nations
Hallelujah.
Of the world.
All the nations.
Ireland, England, Jamaica, Africa, America.
Yes.
We're representing our home, motherland of Africa.
Yes.
Every nation shall bow and praise God and declare He is King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
And our Savior. Amen.
Amen. So, if you're in the area and you want directions on how to get here, you've got little kids, you want a place for them to go, or if you're hungry, you didn't eat this morning, right here at Power Change, you can get all your needs met spiritually and physically.
Amen.
Right here at Power Change. Take a look.
If you are here in the St. Louis metropolitan area, all roads lead to Power of Change. 2348 Jerome Lane, Cahokia Heights, formerly known as Cahokia, Illinois. If you're in St. Louis, just cross the Poplar Street Bridge from Missouri into Illinois and take the first exit towards Cahokia, Illinois Route 3. Continue on Mississippi Avenue for 1 mile. Turn left on Jerome Lane and ride for 3 miles, and the church is on the right. How easy is that? At this very moment, the Power of Change family and friends are pulling up to the church, being welcomed by our team of greeters. We want you to know just how happy we are to see you. And when you're here, not only can you get your soul fed from the Word of God, but your stomach can be fed right here at Inspire Cafe. Delicious breakfast items are served by chefs Brother Lee and Sister Michelle Spearman. This is a great opportunity for you to get something good to eat and fellowship with other Power of Change family members. If you have little ones, they can enjoy playing and burning off that energy at Kids Power Town. Power of Change, Power Kids, has their very own worship service right here at 10:30 a.m.
Awesome, awesome. I love to be able to come here and eat and drop my kid off, okay? And hear the word of God. Amen, amen. So it is time for the Power of Change
social media engagement.
Yay!
All right, get your phones out.
Take these out, right? We use it for our Bibles. Let's take it out for Facebook. We're going to open up Facebook app. At the top, you're going to hit the search or the magnifying glass and type in Power of Change Christian Church. You're going to select follow and then the arrow to share.
Share.
That's how we get out there, okay, you all? We need to make Power of Change known for being the house that serves the Lord.
Yes.
And the house that the Lord dwells in. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. So today we have a question for you all for the social media engagement. Name something that is on your bucket list. Okay, we're going to give you all some time to jot down your answers, and then we're going to come back so that we can review
see
those
your
answers.
Yes. Yeah, we want to see what's on your bucket list. What's something that you've always wanted to do
always
and you want to do
off.
Before you pass away?
Yes.
Because you just never know how long you've got.
No.
You know, and you know, I'm in my 50s, and so as a result, we say that we've got 20 summers left,
yeah.
20 vibrant summers. So, you know, I got to figure out what I'm going to do with them. They will go back quickly. Well, it is the month of April already,
yes.
And already we're halfway through the month of April. Well, in the month of April, I'm so excited because it is officially the National Pickleball Month.
Pickleball.
I am so, because, you know why? I'm a player. I love pickleball. It is a cool sport. I actually started playing it during the pandemic. My family and I were looking for something to do, to get outside, socialize, because we were stuck, what is that?
Quarantine,
shelter in place.
Yep.
And to get out, we decided to start finding things to do. And I went online and found this really cool game called pickleball. It's so simple, it's so easy, it's inexpensive. If you were looking for something to do, and I don't care if you're 10 or 70, you can do it because it's a simple, easy sport to learn. It's kind of like playing ping pong. If you can play ping pong, you can play pickleball.
Okay.
And it's kind of like playing ping pong while standing on the table.
Okay.
And so the same thing. So here's the paddle. The paddle's small, it's lightweight. It's not like tennis where it's heavy and the court is small. And typically, the pickleball court is on a tennis court.
Okay.
There's indoor courts as well. And you play, and the ball is lightweight. It's not like a heavy tennis ball.
Okay.
Lightweight like a wiffle ball. Take a look at this video of some professionals who are playing it, some playing singles and playing doubles, and then my family showing you how simple and easy and fun it is to play pickleball. Put it on your bucket list. Take a look. These paddles are $20 at Walmart. Get it. Get your family moving. Get that body moving. Well, we have moved on to our mission of the month here at Power Change.
And here we have Tammy Jennings.
Tammy.
Hello, hello.
Tammy Jennings. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you? Beautiful.
Thank you.
Gorgeous. Your queen attire.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So, Tammy, tell us how long you've been at Power Change.
I've been here about 12 years. We came when my son was, he wasn't even one yet, so yes.
Wow, 12 years. And since being at Power Change, what ministry have you been a part of?
Well, I've been a part of the intercessory prayer team. I tried the children's ministry, and I do praise and worship.
Amen, amen. And so so.
And evangelism, of course.
And evangelism. Mm-hmm. Okay, the list. All right, a servant of the Lord. Amen. Yes. So our ministry focus for this month is like community, and I know that you're part of the community. You have a organization that you're a part of, or that you started or founded.
Right.
Can you tell us more about that?
Well, God has allowed me to start Esther Serving the Nations. It is a nonprofit 501c3. I am so grateful for it, and it is the heart of God. And basically, I go out to the community and I witness to the people, providing them services and products that they need. But the greatest thing of it all is to win souls for Jesus. That is the purpose. That is the total mission of it, and to give them the love of Jesus Christ. So I partner with other community organizations to make that happen.
That is awesome. So tell us, do you all have anything upcoming? Because I know you did something with Bishop last year, which was awesome and amazing.
Yeah, Night of Hope. That was really cool.
Amen. Yes.
Do you all have anything upcoming?
We do. God has placed it on my heart to do pop-ups around the city where there would be like a little miniature three-song concert. Somebody will administer the word of God, and we'll have an altar call right on the street. And so hopefully we'll have other organizations and evangelism teams from other churches that will come out, because Esther is not a church. We are just a place that provides the love and a care for people that need Jesus, that will not come into the church, but they know they need a touch from Jesus. So we'll pray for them. And if a church is available on the streets with us, they can provide a haven house or a place for them to go after we minister to them. So we'll be doing that. And then October, we plan on partnering with World Vision, Power of Change, and some more city organizations to provide them with a day giveaway. And with this, we'll have World Vision bring a truck in, and they'll just give to the people. This will be a day for them to, you know, some people, they'll never be able to go to the mall. They'll never be able to go shop. And some things we take for granted because we have that option to do. But there are some people that don't. And so this is the day that God wants to love on them and give to them and show them something tangible, because it's not so easy for them to hear you when they're hungry,
right,
or their kids need shoes, or they need a bill paid. But when you can help them and put something in their hand, sometimes they can hear what God has to say to them a little better.
Amen. Well, it shows that God loves them where they are and at that level. Amen. And so if he's concerned about the things that's concerning you, then certainly you can love him back.
Amen.
And so that is beautiful ministry. Esther, Amen. Serving the nations.
Amen.
Awesome.
Bless the Lord.
Well, good. Well, you're going to help us close out the show today. So we're going to, first, what's on your bucket list?
My bucket list.
One thing you want to do. Someplace you want to go.
I would love to go to Paris.
Ooh. It's beautiful. You'll love it. It's
I
amazing.
Love that.
Well, we have plenty of folks online watching. Tawana Cunningham, our faithful director of media.
Dee
Clark, Riley, Sarah McCombs, good morning, Laura Baugh, Verna Allen, Van Life is Worth the Living Prior. Laura, she talked again. Go to Africa. There you go. Here's some things you want to do on your bucket list. Dee Clark says she wants to go to Italy. Jocelyn Neal said go to Italy. All right.
Jocelyn
Tawana wants to go to London. Cheerio, chump. Go to London. Cheerio, family.
Chup, chup.
Chup, chup. Cheerio. Dr. Emita said go to the Kentucky Derby.
Wow.
And wear a big hat.
Oh, wow.
I love that. That is so cool. Good morning, friends, from Linda Braggs. Latia, you're watching?
I am.
You're so
awesome. I may not can be everywhere, but I'm a view. Yeah,
Sherry Brewer, we love you, Sherry.
Amen.
Our post lady. All right.
All right.
Gary Schuler. Good. Awesome.
Amen.
Good morning, people. What's some people here with some bucket list things in our audience that's already here? Who's some bucket list? We hear you.
Go to Lambo.
What's that?
Who? Green Bay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Green Bay Packers. Professional football game.
I don't know about football, so that went over my head. Skydive. Okay, that sounds exciting.
I've done that. That is so cool. Try it.
So if you're in the area, come into the room, you all, and be with us this morning. We would love to see you in person. If you joined here on Facebook, YouTube, or our website, www.poccc.org, we want you to know that we are so happy you tuned in. Don't go anywhere because we're about to begin our Sunday morning celebration. And on behalf of our Bishop Henry and Pastor Patricia Phillips, we want to welcome you to Power of Change, the church that is changing lives.
Welcome.
Amen.
Welcome. Good morning.
Welcome to Power of Change Christian Church, where we are expanding the kingdom of God by empowering people to discover, develop, and demonstrate their divine destinies. Now let's take a look at our upcoming events. Power of Change, let's reach our social media goal to reach over 10,000 viewers by going live now on Facebook and sharing with our family and friends. This month's focus is mission by impacting the world for Christ. Remember to invite at least two people to church. Join Bishop Henry Phillips for his sermon series, Open Doors. 2024 is the year for open doors. Invite your family and friends for this life-changing sermon. We will be loving on our Bishop Henry Phillips for his birthday on April 21st. On behalf of the entire Power of Change family, we salute you, man of God, and wish you a very happy birthday. Join us for Maplewood Elementary Lunch with a Loved One on Thursday, April 25th. Feel free to bring a child and yourself a special lunch as we enjoy a dessert and take photos. If you are interested in participating, please scan the QR code. The C3 Leaders and Workers Meeting will be held on Thursday, April 25th at 7 p.m. Come out as Bishop and Pastor share information about the church. Destiny Graduation will be held on Sunday, April 28th during service. The deadline to sign up is April 21st. Please stop by the membership table or for more information, you can sign up there. Bring the youth out on Sunday, April 28th during our 10 a.m. service for Youth Takeover. Let's support our youth as they take over service. If you would like to participate in the Grief Support Balloon Release to be held on Saturday, May 4th at 11 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. in the parking lot, please scan the QR code or text Memorial to 618-243-7307. If you are looking for a church home, then Power of Change is the place for you. We have various ministries that you can be a part of. If you would like to sign up, please stop by the Get Connected table. If you are interested in helping to plan the 30th anniversary, there will be a meeting after service in the Inspire Cafe with Deaconess Larez Rouse. Also, directly after service, the youth will be having a snack shop from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Let's support our youth. And that's what's happening at Power of Change. For more information, you can visit us on Facebook at Power of Change Christian Church USA and visit us on the web at www.poccc.org.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
Hallelujah. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. Welcome on this International Sunday.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. No matter where you're from, where you originated from, I'm sure they praise the Lord. I'm sure they bless God. So on this morning, you and our streaming audience get a chance to bless the Lord with us. Don't change that dial, streaming audience. You came to the right place. I want you to stand to your feet if you can and help us bless the Lord on this morning. Come on, let me hear you say hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's bless the Lord.
We gotta move. We gotta move. We gotta move.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Glory to your name, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We gotta move, y'all, like y'all know that God is good or something in this building. Y'all act like y'all done been through something in here and you had to use your praise as a weapon.
Yeah. Glory, glory, glory.
Yeah. Yeah. We gotta move. We gotta move. We gotta move. We're gonna do another song that y'all know too. Y'all can sing this one out with us. Let's go, Max. You can stay on your feet for this one too. It got a little bounce to it. Yeah. Come on. Everybody. Everybody sing this out. It's simple as says this. Should I owe him all the praise? Should I owe him praise forever and always? I'll choose to bless his name. I'll bless his name. Y'all know that one, right? Take it up again. Yeah. Chicago. Yes, I do.
sing, bless your name. God, I'll give you the praise. Yeah, one more time, say
forever and always.
Sing, yeah, I'll bless your name.
We serve the worthy God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We want to welcome you guys into the service. Hallelujah. This is our time of corporate prayer. Hallelujah. Don't shut down on me. Come on. We got to go higher. We don't want to just plateau and fall off. Let's go higher. Hallelujah. We invite you, Holy Spirit, into this place. Come in. Hallelujah, Father. Open our ears and our eyes in the Spirit, Lord God. Let us hear your voice, your wisdom, and your instructions, God. Father, we pray, Lord God, that your Holy Spirit will put each and every one of us under arrest, my God. Father, that we will be obedient to your voice and your instructions, God. That we will walk out every ordered steps. Come on, don't sit down on me. Hallelujah. I'll get out the way if you get with me. Hallelujah, Father, in Jesus' name, God. Father, we just want you to come in and have your way, God. We want to set the atmosphere right now, my God, for where preaching will be easy, Lord God. Teaching understandable, God. Hearts receptive, my God. Hallelujah. We press past our yesterday, God, and we step into our new day, God. Father, in Jesus' name, we glorify you today, God. Father, you are doing a new thing, Lord God. Father, every door you put before us, God. Father, we examine that door, my God, according to your word and your wisdom, God. Father, every door and every season that is ours, God, we receive it now, my God, because you said no good thing would you withhold from us. Oh, God, we lift up our voice, oh, God. We cry out to you. We honor you, my God, for there is none like you, oh, God. Hallelujah, if the people of God, come on. Hallelujah, shout to your God. He is the God of victory. Hallelujah, he is our present help. He is our source and our strength. Hallelujah, God, we glorify you. Father, look upon our situations, God. Father, we put them behind us, God, and we stretch forth our hand and say, Father, I have need of thee. You are bigger and greater than our situation, God. You are bigger and greater than our trials, oh God. But Father, we know that your word decrees that I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Oh, we step in the authority and anointing of a king's kid. And we thank you today, oh God. We bless you today, my God. Hallelujah. And we exalt you, Lord God. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Shabbat the Lord in this place.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Well, this is the day that the Lord has made. I choose to rejoice and be glad in it. Not only am I glad in it, I choose and I make a conscious effort to rejoice and be glad in this day that the Lord has made. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, this is a time of our service where we're going to dedicate our babies unto the Lord. How many of you know that our babies are a precious gift from God? Hallelujah. So with the families of Zayden Harrison, Alea Outlaw, Kenju Sales, and Gianni West, please come forward at this time. Family and friends. Hallelujah.
Can we give the Lord a hand praise, everybody? Oh, come on, do better than that. Give the Lord a good praise. I want to make sure that we understand the beauty of what's happening right now. This is not just seeing children being prayed over, but this is our first course of action to speak destiny into their lives. And I am so grateful that we have this opportunity to love our children. I'm going to ask that the babies that we are going to dedicate, they will come up just a little closer. Yeah, thank you, Father God. Elder Keith, I'm going to speak a blessing, but I want you to speak a blessing also over your grandson. Which babies am I doing right here? I'm doing him, I'm doing her, and I'm doing him. Amen. You don't know who you're holding or who you have in your possession, because this may be the greatest leader of the next generation. They may have the cure of cancer in their DNA. And that's the reason why we keep them before the Lord. We don't want to just pray over them. We want to stay in the presence of the Lord. I'm a product of a parent that stayed in the presence of the Lord. And I believe that God is going to do something special as we pray activation of destiny in their lives. Kelsey, this boy has not stopped looking at me. He's been checking me out. Can we all pray at this time? And Father, we say thank you. Thank you, oh God, for the destiny lives that we have. We speak blessings over this next generation. We speak blessings over his covering, over his parent. Father God, I pray that in the name of Jesus, that the blessings that you have for them, that Father God, it will activate today. Activate today. His steps is ordered by you. And Father, I thank you that you have given him a guardian angel. I thank you for his covering. I thank you, O God, that you're giving her discernment to just know, O God, what's happening in her child's life. And God, you and her will bring him forth into the destiny you have called him to. I pray, oh God, for this baby right here in the name of Jesus. I pray, oh God, that you bring blessings to her life. I speak right now the favor of the Lord be upon her in the name of Jesus. I pray, oh God, that her mother would know that, God, you will perfect everything that concerns her and the child. God, the covering, the mothers, the grandmothers, the grandfathers, everyone that is connected, God, blessings is upon them right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we lift this son up, the son of destiny, to you right now, God. Thank you, oh God, that favor is being activated right now. Blessings is being activated right now. And God, you're going to do what only you can do in the name of Jesus. And Father, I speak every chapter of his life is blessed. Every season of his life is blessed in the name of Jesus. Yes, hallelujah.
And Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father.
Yes.
We ask you to bless this male child, God. In this name of Jesus Christ, Father, we pray, God, that your blessings rest mightily upon him, God.
Yes.
Father, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that no weapon formed against him shall prosper, God. That destiny will come forth, God. Your purpose, God, the reason that you spoke him into existence, Father, will come forth, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. And every force of hell we come against right now, Father, in Jesus' name, Father, he will do what you said that he's going to do, Father. He will be who you want him to be, Father. We speak it over his life right now, Father, in Jesus' name, Father, that he will be a servant of you, Father. He will love you, Father, with all his heart and soul, Father. He will serve you, Father, all the days of his life, Father. Order his steps right now, God, in Jesus' name. Even before he starts stepping, Father, let his steps be ordered right now, God, in Jesus' name. Let him crawl into destiny, Father. Let him run into destiny, Father, in Jesus' name, Father. We speak your blessings, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father. And we call him blessed, God.
We call him blessed.
We call him holy, God.
Yes.
We call him righteous, Father. We call him a son of God. We call him a man of God. Right now, Father, in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Have your way, Holy Spirit. Let him be led by your spirit. Let him know your voice, God. In Jesus' name, Father. And purpose shall prevail in Satan's life. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Come on and give God some praise. God, the prayers that was prayed is over every child, over every family. I pray over this village for every child. God, let the village know you. Because the times that we are living in now, if we ever needed an ark of safety, we need it now. And we pray over their destiny. Every chapter of their lives is blessed and victorious. In Jesus' name, clap your hands one more time and give the Lord a hand. Praise everybody. Or you can do better than that. Give God some praise. God, I bless her in Jesus' name. That Father, she's not here by accident.
Yes, yes.
But God, you are activating purpose, promises around her life.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, amen. Parents, are you committed to model before your children a life of destiny, and that you are committed to make sure that they know the God of their faith, and to do everything that you possibly can to empower them for the kingdom destiny that God wants them to live? If you're committed, say, I will. Village, are you willing to support these parents so when the children come over to your house, they ain't seeing 10 different house versions? They need to see one village, one version. Are you committed to support them and help them raise their children in the right way they should go? If you will, say, we will. Church, are we committed to pray for our children? Pray for these families that destiny will prevail. Somebody's going to have to take this pulpit over one day. We've got to prepare another generation. If you're committed, say, we will. Father, you have heard our prayers over these families, and we speak destiny, life over these children. And we give you the praise for this new chapter, the guardian angels over them, and the life you call them to live. In Jesus' name, and the people of God say, amen. Amen. Now listen, I'm just going to hold up one and Deaconess is going to give it to you all because you all speaking in tongues with these names and I can't. I ain't going to even try. I wasn't good in Spanish or any of that. Parents, let me say this. I want you to take these certificates and I want you to put them in a special place. And I want you to use, especially in times of prayer, especially, where I know you from? Morning Star, I figured that, all right. Listen, I want you to take these and put them in a special place. And I want you to use this for prayer. Because as they get older and go into different chapters of life, the enemy is going to try to pull them in the way that they're not supposed to go. And I want you to pull this certificate out and I want you to pray. And I want you to say, God, remember, we have a covenant. I need you to do what I can't do. I need you to bring him into the destiny, bring her into the destiny that you've called them to. And then I want you to speak to the devil and say, devil, it's too late. My child is certified, bona fide, chosen, and you can't have them. Amen? Can we give these families a round of applause, everybody? God bless you. You may take your seat, and after church, if you want to come up to take pictures, feel free to come up and take pictures. We'll just let them go. You can give it to them at another time. Amen. Can we give God some praise this morning, everybody? Oh, my God. Listen, I want to say happy International Sunday and what have you. I'm dressed the way that I'm dressed because I'm doing an illustrated sermon. And so I'm getting ready to leave and get set up for the illustrated sermon today. We're going to have a good time today. We're teaching on the door, open doors. Somebody say the open doors. And we are supposed to close on today. We're just going to see what the Lord says. Amen. Elder Brian is going to come and he's going to do the pastoral reflections and the offering. And then we're going into the sermon for the morning. Amen. Amen. Give him a hand as he come at this time.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, somebody. Come on, can you clap your hands and open up your mouth and give God your best praise? Come on, you can do better than that. Can you clap your hands? Come on, can you change the atmosphere in here? Come on, I heard the song said every round goes higher and higher. And we're getting ready to go higher. If you want to go higher, can you clap your hands and open up your mouth? And all the victorious people shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Come on, you can do better than that. You're almost there. Oh, clap your hands, all ye people. And shout unto God with the voice of triumph. You're almost there. The Bible said, oh, clap your hands, all ye people. And shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Any victorious people here this morning? Well, if you got the victory, can you open your mouth and declare, I got the victory? Can you open your mouth and declare that you made it another week? Tell somebody, hell had an assignment, but he lost again. I made it another week. I don't care what came my way, it came, and I made it through it. Anybody said, I made it to the 14th day of April. And I'm still here to declare that God is a good God. Can you clap your hands and open up your mouth if you know God is a good God? Can you clap your hands and open up your mouth if God is a worthy God? Can you clap your hands and open up your mouth if you know we serve a big God? Can you clap your hands and open up your mouth if you know we serve a consistent God? Now, if you know he's just good, 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 take about 60 seconds and praise your good God. Don't hide behind the music. Don't hide behind the organ. Don't hide behind the drums. But open your mouth and give him a thank you, Jesus, praise. I thank you I made it another week. I thank you I'm in my right mind. I Take that, I gotta. Tell your neighbor, say neighbor, it's hard to think and not thank. But every time I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah. I thank God for saving me. Now this is what we gonna praise God for. Because most people only praise God for the benefits of what he done for you, the house, the car, the job, and all those other things. But I want to take 30 seconds and go back to when you first got saved. And I want you to take a few seconds and praise God for just salvation. I know it ain't your car, but can you just praise God for salvation? That I got a new lease on life. That if I die tonight, I can meet him in paradise. And just take a few seconds, come on musicians, and just praise God that you saved. And in your right mind, can you praise him for salvation? Come on, let's praise him for salvation. Because I can tell by your reaction, y'all not glad about y'all salvation. Be seated, go head on and sit down. But can you look at a neighbor and say, neighbor, I had a first class ticket to hell, but God canceled it when he intervened on my bad life. Tell him I was going fast to hell, but God intervened and saved my life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Pastor. And you greet your person to your neck, your left, and your right, and just tell them it's good to see you this morning. It's good to see you. It's good to see you. Please be seated. Amen. While you're welcoming them, we want to welcome our streaming audience. Come on, let's welcome our streaming audience. And while you're on the online, do us a favor and like, comment, and share. Tell somebody, don't go anywhere. Our bishop is getting ready to preach an awesome word. Listen, musicians, y'all making it real tough for me this morning. Because I remember where I was when God found me. And I remember the shape I was in when God found me. And I thank God because he gave me chance after chance to get it right. And anybody excited this morning that the Lord didn't give up on you? You ought to tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, the reason why I'm so excited this morning, because there were several opportunities that he had to give up on me, but he kept remembering me. And I thank God that he remembered me. First-time guests, come on, come on, lift up a shout and praise God that he remembered you. Amen. Please be seated. Please be seated. Listen, we need all our first-time guests, all our first-time guests, please wave your hand. All first-time guests, all first-time guests, all first-time guests, wave your hands. There's some over here, there's some over here, there's some over here. Come on, let's thank God for our first-time guests. If you just keep your hands up, we have something that we want you to get and fill out. We want to be a blessing to you. We have something we need to get to you. All first-time guests, all first-time. Listen, if you're looking for a church home, we invite you to consider Power of Change. Amen. Amen. Listen, anybody got your monthly invite cards? Your monthly invite cards? Your monthly invite cards? Tell somebody, get some monthly invite cards. And we want to make sure that we're inviting. We're inviting. We're inviting. Look, we're inviting. Tell somebody next Sunday.
Sunday, next Sunday, next Sunday. I need everybody. I need you to get on the phone, Lottie, Dottie, and everybody. All those who love our pastor and excited about his life, just clap your hands. Those who love our pastor and excited about his life. Listen, on next Sunday, we're going to be celebrating his life. Amen. We're celebrating our bishop's birthday on next Sunday. And you don't want to miss that. We're going to celebrate our bishop really good. We got some guests that are going to be here with us. You don't want to miss next week. And listen, this is what I need you to do. I need you to get me, do something this week. Go and purchase our bishop something. Get him a card. Fill that card up. We want to, and when I say fill that card up, fill it up with something good. Amen. You know how when you get a card, you open your card up. First thing, you know, whenever we get cards, we don't even read the card first. We want to see what's inside the card. So next week, we want to make sure that our bishop, when he opened up every card that he get, it's something nice on the inside of that card. We want to be a blessing to our bishop. Anybody going to help me bless our bishop on next week? Listen, I'm buying him a gift and I'm going to put something in the card. So I want you to do me a favor. Follow the leader. We're going to, now you might not be able to buy him a gift and get him a card and put something in it, but do your very best on next week. I want us to be a blessing to our bishop, our man of God. Listen, he is our father, he is our leader, and when we bless the prophet, we get the prophet's reward, amen? And we want to make sure that we be a blessing to him. Happy International Sunday on today, amen? Happy International Sunday. I'm still trying to hold myself back. Happy International Sunday. Listen, immediately right after church, say right after church, right after church. Listen, we are embarking upon our 30th year anniversary. And anybody that's looking to be a part of the committee for our 30th year anniversary, I need you to do me a favor. Deacon Larez and myself, we're going to be in the cafe after worship is over. And if you want to be a part of the 30th year planning, you want to be a part of it in any way, shape, form, or fashion, please do me a favor and meet us in the cafe. Amen. And I want to make sure that you're part of. There are so many things that we need to do to get done for our 30th year anniversary. And we want you, yeah, and especially you, if you like to be a part of it. Amen. So if you want to be a part of it in any way, we'll fill you in this afternoon, right after service. Deacon Larez and myself would be in the cafe. Amen. Anybody want to be a part of our church anniversary? Anybody excited about 30 years? Amen. Amen. Tell somebody Mother's Day. Mother's Day. Mother's Day, listen, Mother's Day is coming up, and I want you to do me a favor. Invite your mothers, invite your grandmothers, invite everybody to be a part of Mother's Day on May 12th. We want to be here, and we thank God for our spiritual mother. Let's thank God for Pastor. She's here. We thank God for her. Listen, we can't celebrate Mother's Day without celebrating our mama. So we're going to celebrate mama too. So thank you all. Everybody's standing. Tell somebody it's good to be in the house of the Lord. One more time. Listen, prepare yourself for your tithes and offering. Get your gift in your hand. Come on, let's pray. Still, if you need to turn in your pledge, hallelujah. If you need to turn in your pledge, turn in your pledge. We are getting ready to transform this stage. Our bishop has a wonderful vision, and we want to make sure that vision comes to pass. And I want to see that that vision comes to pass. Amen. So if you still have pledge money, please make sure you turn it in. Come on, let's pray. Father, we thank you. We love you. We honor you. We do adore you, God. We thank you for another opportunity, God. Now we're giving into good ground, God, and we knowing, God, that a harvest shall come on our behalf. God, we praise you, God, for all you have done. God, you have not caused our life to lack in any area. But God, abundance has been our order. And we give you praise for how you continue to bless us and how you continue to make ways and how you continue to bless Power of Change. We thank you for what you're going to do and how you're going to do it. We give you praise and we give you honor in the great name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and thank God. Listen, there are several ways you can give. See the screen for the ways of giving. Let's follow the direction of our ushers in the hands of our praise team. And then our bishop is coming to give us a word. Let's receive them in that order. God bless you. You all.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, help me sing.
So I need to know where I need to go. 'Cause I'm one of the grateful people. Show me the grateful.
people up in here. God, show up hands. Let me see you. If you're grateful. Yeah. And if you're screaming and you're feeling grateful, type grateful. Hallelujah. Come on, help us sing this next part. Ooh, yeah, yeah. For waking me up this morning.
Give him a hand praise right now. Rest on your feet, everyone. I want to move expeditiously into the Word of God. Are you all excited about this Sunday morning? I want you to stand as the custom as we prepare to read the Word of the Lord on today. I want to go to Genesis chapter 41. Worship team, thank you so much for setting the atmosphere. Listen, it is not their job to entertain you. That's not what they're called to do. We don't have a scorecard on them. We have a scorecard on ourselves when we come into the presence of the Lord. Genesis chapter 41, and I'm going to read sketchy on this because it's so rich, but it would take too long to go through all of this, so just have to follow me. Verse 1, and it says this: when 2 years had passed, Pharaoh had a dream. He was standing by the Nile. Verse 9, then the chief cupbearer said to Pharaoh, "Today I am reminded of my shortcomings." Verse 12. Now the young Hebrew was there with us, a servant of the captain of the guard. We told him our dreams, and he interpreted them for us, giving each man the interpretation of his dream. Verse 14. So Pharaoh sent for Joseph, and he was quickly brought out of the dungeon. Watch this. When he had shaved and changed his clothes, he came before Pharaoh. I'm going to say it again. When he had shaved and changed his clothes, he came before Pharaoh. You know, I can read on. There's so much more, but I think that's where I want to land right now. So Pharaoh sent for Joseph, and he was quickly brought out of the dungeon. When he was shaved, somebody said, when he was shaved and changed his clothes, he came before Pharaoh. I want to use as a title on today, I'm ready for my new doors. I'm ready. Can you help me? Can you help me? Can you help me? Can you help me? Just look at three people and just declare what's going on with you right about now. Tell them, I'm ready for my new doors. Tell one more. I'm ready for my new doors. Yes, I am, sis. And Father God, we thank you for who you are in our lives, and we thank you because there is an anointing that has come to break every yoke. Spirit of the living God, I thank you right now that there are warring angels that has come to bring us out of the dungeons that we have been held up long enough. And Father, I pray that as we minister and as we speak, oh God, that God, you will begin to open the heavens, and God, begin to rattle the dungeons, begin to rattle every prison. God, it is our time for kingdom parolement and to step into destiny. God, grace us to preach today, and we thank you that we won't be the same again. In Jesus' name we pray, thank God. Clap your hands and give God a praise for the word. Come on, don't panic. Give him the praise for the word that you're about to receive. Well, be seated in the presence of the Lord. Be seated in the presence of the Lord. Well, while you're taking your seat, say it one more time. I'm ready for my new doors. We've been teaching a series on open doors, that this year is open doors. The Hebrew calendar gives the symbol of an open door. And it is important that you understand God is trying to let you know that you are in transition, that there are things that are happening intentionally in and around your life because it is time for you to go into another dimension. Is anybody talking to me today? Now, there are some things that I want to do, and today, really, I'm finishing this series. We started on Easter talking about the open door through Christ, and how many enjoyed the word on last Sunday? And I was planning to finish, but I got to meditating and doing devotion on this passage of Scripture, and I already know that this is going to be part one. I don't know when I'm doing part two, but just come to church. Everybody say doors. There are all types of doors that I can teach on, but I want to deal with four doors, three real quick, and one I want to really focus on. The first door that I want, and you may want to write this down, the first door that I want to deal with is the asking door. The asking door. Everybody say the asking door. Say it real loud, the asking door. Now, you know when I get ready to preach, we all preach together. Say amen, somebody. It's not Bishop preaching. The whole church is preaching. Everybody say, the asking door. Now, notice what it says in Matthew's chapter 7, 7 and 8. Matthew's chapter 7, 7 and 8, when we're talking about the asking door. Let me give you the other doors, and then I'm going to break them down. First one is going to be the asking door. The second one is going to be the show up door. Help God, the show up doors. The third one is going to be the timing doors. The timing doors. And the fourth one is going to be the destiny doors. The destiny doors. Let's talk number one, the asking door. Say it please one more time. The asking door. Matthew 7, 7 and 8 says this, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find, look at this, knock, and it will be open to you. Knock, and it will be open to you. Have you ever knocked on a door and you did not get what you was looking for? Have you ever knocked on a door and nobody answered? Please understand this, because this is very important and very imperative that you understand that this passage is about the power of continuation. Please hear me. It is about the power of continuation. In other words, keep on knocking until the door opens. In other words, this is about prayer, that God is saying, seek me and go after me until you get what you want. But let me give you some natural applications to it. Every door is not the door. I'm gonna wait till y'all unthaw real quick. Every door is not the door. Some of us, the reason why we have not come into our blessing is because we keep knocking at the wrong door. Don't you hear the theme music of that door that says keep a knocking, but you can't? I knew y'all wasn't saved. That's the reason why y'all slowed. You have to recognize that God is saying to you, if that door don't open, go to the next door. Look at somebody and say, go to the next door. Go to the next door, because there is a door that has your name on it. There is a door that will recognize your knock. There is a door that God has prepared for you. And the Bible says that the blessings of the Lord maketh rich and add no sorrow. Some of the doors that you're trying to go into is going to be full of sorrow. And so God is saying to you right now that I'm trying to bring you to a place where there is no sorrow in your life. I need you to just lift up your hands, because I want to declare some things over you right now. I pray that this year that you will keep knocking until you find your right door. Come on, receive it right now. Receive it right now. I pray this year that you will knock and that you will soon come into all of the blessings, all of the favor that that door has for you. You will not miss that door. That door will not leave your season until you hit it. Can you give God a real praise up in this place right now? Can you really lift up? I don't know what door you're at, but your door needs to hear your voice. Your door needs to hear your knock. Your door needs to hear your faith. Somebody say the asking door. Door number two, the show up doors. The show up doors. Now, what is the show up doors? Have you ever seen a door that you just walk to and it opens when you get to it? Y'all just really gonna be quiet over here, huh? Have you ever just been at that door that you didn't even have to knock? You didn't have to use a key to unlock? You didn't even have to touch it? It don't even have any handles. All it is waiting on is to sense your presence. It's waiting for you to rise and show up. Y'all quiet up in this place. So you must understand, my brothers and sisters, the problem with many of our victories is that we are failing to show up. We didn't gave up before we didn't got started. We didn't quit before we have gone the extra mile. But if you would dare say, I'm not going to stop until I get to the door, because when you get there, it's been waiting on you. When you get there, it knows your presence. When you get there, it's a sign to open up. Some of y'all ready to roll up your sleeves and work hard. You don't really recognize that God says it's your season. And when it is your season, favor will open the door. Tell somebody it's time for you to show up. Tell somebody it's time for you to show up. Slip those hands up one more time. Let me declare another word over you right now. I pray this year that you will show up to the doors that's waiting for your arrival. I pray that you will fill out that application. I pray that you will go to that business meeting. I pray that you will sign up for the ministry you're called to. I pray that you will reconcile relationships so you can be healed. It is time for you to show up and receive what God has for you in this season. Can you seal it with a praise right there? Can you seal it with a real praise right there? I don't want your hands. I want your faith. I want your faith. I need your faith to come with me. Number three, the timing doors. Oh, God, help me here. The timing doors. Everybody say the timing doors. Say it again, the timing doors. Please look at this because King Solomon talks about this particular door. You know, we say, Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 11, we say that the race is not given to the, you know, I used to preach, the race is not given to the swift, nor the battle is to the strong, but to the one that endured to the end. How many heard that before? That's not quite what the scripture says. So let's get what the scripture is saying right there. Look what it says here in the New King James. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 11. It says, for the race is not given to the swift. Please hear this. Nor the battle to the strong, nor the bread to the wise, nor riches to the understanding, nor favor to men of skills. But time and chance happen to them all. Let me see if I can help you here. The Living Bible says this, but it is all by chance, by happen to be at the right place at the right time. Somebody say, break it down, Bishop. In other words, the Bible is saying here, the Bible is saying that many people that you are seeing prospering, many people that you are seeing blessed is not smarter than you. They're not smarter than you. Many people that you're seeing prosper and being blessed, that they don't work any harder than you. Many people that are prosperous and living a blessed life, that they're not more talented than you. Watch this. Please hear what I'm about to say. They were simply at the right place at the right time to encounter favor. I listen to the singers in this church, and my God, we've got some incredible singers, some incredible people that are anointed of God. And I look at some of the folks that's on the national stage, and I'm like, my God, they need so-and-so to sing right there. They need this person to sing right there. They're not more talented. They just was next to a producer. They can't act better than you. They don't have better business skills than you. They was just next to the boss. I'm gonna wait till y'all respond back to me. And this is the season that God says, I need you to get next to the revolving door. The timing door is the revolving door. There's a certain time when that door will open up. Y'all quiet up in here. There's a certain time that that door, and it's time for you to get in the right place, in the right position, at the right time to step in, because that door is going to usher you into the place of favor. I need you to lift up those hands. Let's declare something right now. I pray that this year God will put you in the right place at the right time. I pray that you will not miss key opportunities over your life. I pray that you will synchronize in rhythm with the timing of God for your next promotion in the name of the Lord Jesus. If you really believe it and really receive it, clap your hands of faith and seal it right now. Come on, seal it, seal it, seal it. I speak the right timing over your life. But then the last one is the one that I want to give timing to. Everybody say, the destiny doors. Say it again, the destiny doors. I want to give the rest of my time to this door, because we see our focus on this door will be from the life of Joseph. Please understand, when we talk about Joseph, we look at his background. Joseph, we know him as being the dreamer. Imagine Joseph, the young man with the dream of greatness, the dream of leadership, the dream of making a difference in the world. world, and yet and still he is walking not in the path that he envisioned for his life. He was betrayed by his brothers. He finds himself confined within the walls of a prison, accused of a crime that he did not commit. This was not how he saw his journey unfolding. This was not the greatness he had in mind. Can we talk for 1 second here? How many of us have had dreams and aspirations that seem to crumble before our eyes? How many of us have faced setbacks and disappointments that left questions in our life that, am I really a person of purpose, or am I just dreaming that I've got purpose? I'm just dreaming that I have a real destiny. I am dreaming that God wants to use me. We've got to understand that just because it's not happening the way that we thought it was going to happen doesn't mean that God is not up to something. Section A, I need y'all to talk to me up in here. It may look like you are in a prison, but God is perfecting something. I feel like preaching this morning. God is perfecting something in your life. Can you clap and thank him for something being perfected in your life? Tell somebody, it looks like it's a setback, but it's really a setup. Watch this, my brothers. Watch this, my sisters, because I want to go deeper now. Because what do you do when you find, oh, God help me, your purpose in your prison? You was waiting to get out of prison to do your purpose, just to find out that your purpose is waiting for you in prison. What do you do when you find that your purpose is built into your disappointment? In other words, in order for your purpose to come, you had to be scheduled with a particular disappointment. It was that disappointment that activated your purpose. Y'all still gonna be quiet up on me up in here? Look at this. Because when we look at this situation, Joseph's ministry began to grow while being in prison. It was in the midst of his suffering and in the depthness of his despair that Joseph found himself being a minister to other prisoners. When you need help yourself, God requires you to help somebody else. I need somebody to holler prison ministry. Say it one more time, prison ministry. Isn't it something how God, before he answers your prayers, he will call you to become an answer to someone else's prayers? Isn't it something that before God would give you a free ministry or a freedom ministry, he will call you into some type of personal prison ministry? Some of you all are dealing with a marital prison ministry. Some of you all are dealing with health prison ministry. Some of you all are dealing with somebody that betrayed you, somebody that let you down, disappointments, bad decisions in your life, and you are feeling the pain and the suffering from it, but that pain and that suffering is squeezing something out of you that's going to bless you in your future. I wish somebody would clap and give God some praise on that. Yeah. Watch this, my brother and sister. Look at this. You're fighting discouragement yourself, and yet still God doesn't give you a word for yourself. He gives you a word for somebody else. And you keep asking God, God, when you gonna send somebody to give me a word from me? I'm always talking about somebody. I'm always discerning somebody. I'm already ministering to somebody else. They jumping and shouting, talking about that's my word. God, I want to know, when do I get a word from my circumstance, a word from my situation? I'm tired of being strong for everybody else. I'm tired of carrying everybody else. I'm tired of lifting up everybody else. When do I get my lifter? When do I get my help? When do I get my support system? Tell somebody you in a prison ministry. So watch this, my sisters. Watch this, my brother. Can I go just a little deeper here? Because you are in pain, but you are anointed for someone else's healing. Tell somebody, I know this is a hard place. Tell them, I know this is a hard place, but you are anointed for this. How in the world can you be going through your depression and still seeing somebody else happy, preach somebody else happy, sow into somebody else's life? Tell somebody you are anointed for this. Look at this. Look at this. I need a prayer team. I need somebody to pray because we've got to birth something today. Look at this. Little did Joseph know that his ministry in prison was paving the way for his destiny outside of prison. Okay, let me see if I can say it one more time. He didn't know that his ministry in prison was paving the way for his destiny outside of prison. See, we think when we get out of our situation, we're going to be ready. But the God that we serve, he know how to do 10 things at one time. He know how to perfect 10 things at one time. He allow you to go through some things because he needs to work on you. But while he's working on you, he's also working on your future. Oh, can I talk about it? You see, it would be 2 years later that Joseph had ministered to a cupbearer. And the cupbearer said that I saw 3 branches of grapes. And the grapes that I saw was fresh grapes. And that I squeezed it and I put it in the cup of Pharaoh and gave him the cup. That was 2 years prior to this chapter, because he said to him, Joseph said to him, he said, in 3 days, you saw 3 branches. He said, in 3 days, Pharaoh's going to get you out of this dungeon. He's going to get you out of this dungeon, and he's going to restore you to be his cupbearer again. In 3 days, he's going to do that. Isn't it somehow God give you specific for everybody else? But you... In 3 days, God's going to give you what you need. He said, now listen, when God does it, don't forget me. That's all I'm asking you to do. Don't forget me, because I'm not here because I did something wrong. I'm here because of being falsely accused of doing something. Don't forget me. The Bible says in chapter 40, the Bible says, and when the cupbearer was restored, he forgot about Joseph. Isn't that something, how people that you ministered to and how people that you blessed and how people that you touched and you spoke into their life, you counseled them, you travailed over them, you ministered to them, you sowed wealth and finances into their life, and then when they start doing good, they forgot all about you. Y'all don't have any of those kind of testimonies, huh? They forgot how you supported them. They forgot how you used to take them to work every day because they didn't have a job and didn't have enough money for a bus ticket. There's just a few of us that got that testimony that we sold into somebody else's life, and yet they forgot all. Forgot all about you. Watch this. Some of you are waiting until things get better, but God says, I need you in your prison to start ministering. And watch me take your ashes and make beauty out of it. Can you clap and give God some praise on that? Please look at this. Let's go deeper into this story, because I got to get into the prison. Watch this. Pharaoh, which is the name of a king, an Egyptian king, had a dream that seven cows was ate by seven skinny cows, and seven grains of wheat was eaten by seven skinny grains of wheat. And he needed someone to interpret, because no one could interpret the dream. This is too years later. And it was at this time that the cupbearer says, I have sinned, because there was a guy that ministered to me in my prison, ministered to me in my confusion, ministered to me in my challenging time, that gave me an answer. And Pharaoh, if you get him out, I promise you, he'll speak into your life. Sometimes God would allow people to forget you because you're not ready to come out yet. Section D, I'm about to prophesy some over there, because y'all ain't acting right. Sometimes God will allow things to happen because it's not time for you to come out yet. But how many know that when the right time comes, it may look like you're on layaway, but you're going to come out of this. And the Bible says in Genesis 41 and 14, it says, then Pharaoh sent, watch this, please hear me, please watch this, sent and called Joseph, and they brought him hastily out of the dungeon, and he shaved, and I'm reading out of the King James, I love the King James. The King James said, and he shaved himself. Somebody say, shave yourself. And changed his raiment and came unto Pharaoh. Let's break that down and we're going to let it go. Watch this. Number one, he came out hastily. He came out suddenly. I want to prophesy to someone about your future, because your destiny door is so powerful until it can break your dungeon doors. Y'all didn't hear what I just said. In other words, your destiny door don't have to beg your prison doors. Please let them out. I want to use them. Please let them out. They got a gift. They got an anointing. No, 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 no. When you come into your destiny door will roll away a stone. Your destiny door will bust the door down. The destiny door will break every gate, break every chain. Y'all quiet up in here. God is saying that if you ever wait on your destiny door. Y'all quiet up in here. Whatever you're at, whatever situation, I don't care if you're in the hospital, your destiny door will raise you up out of the bed. I don't care if you're in the prison, the destiny door will set up your parole man. Somebody said, God, I thank you for my destiny door. Watch this. There was no hesitation. It happened suddenly. What you've been wrestling with for years, God can change it suddenly. I can tell y'all shouted too long up in here because y'all tired. Y'all tired up in here, and God's giving you your now word. Listen to me right now. God is saying, get ready for a suddenly. Get ready. You have waited long enough. You've prayed long enough. You shouted long enough. Tell somebody, no more delays, no more delays, no more delays, no more hold up, no more hold up. It's time for a shift in your life. Can you really get happy about a shift? Can you really get happy about a change? Can you really get happy about a suddenly? It can happen in one day. It can happen in 1 hour. It can happen in 1 minute. It can happen with one phone call. It can happen in one email. I don't know when it's going to happen, but I'm a praiser, because when it happened, I'm ready. Can I go deeper? I said, can I go deeper? Please hear this. So watch this. It opened suddenly. It opened suddenly. But look at this. Because when I read this, this is what made this sermon be two parts, because I couldn't get past this verse right here. It says, and I'm reading out of the King James Version, it says, and he shaved himself. And he shaved himself and changed his raiment before he came to Pharaoh. Somebody say, break it down. Please understand the text, the context of this scripture concerning the beard. He shaved himself. I need you to understand this, because while this passage is condemning wearing a beard, this passage is only dealing with it from an Egyptian standpoint. I can show you in other scriptures that God honors a beard, but this is dealing with being in Egypt, because in ancient Egypt, the Egyptians required the men to be clean shaved. To be clean shaved and to be well groomed was to not have a beard on. And the only time you were allowed in ancient Egypt to wear a beard is when you was in mourning or if you was a slave. I'm trying to find my crowd up in here. Come on, Brother Keith Chapman, I need you to tell Vicky to holler at her little brother. Watch this here. It's time for you to understand that he said, I will no longer be in mourning. I will no longer be a slave. Before I go into my future, before I go into my next level, I'm not going to look like my past. I'm going to look like my future. I wish I had 10 people up in here that I'm speaking down in your spirit. Joseph was saying, watch this, Joseph's destiny, please hear this. Joseph's destiny was ready. His gift, his interpretation of dreams was ready. The destiny door is ready. But watch this. He wasn't ready. The door was ready. The season was ready. Pharaoh was ready. But he wasn't ready. Anybody talking to me? He, please hear what I'm about to say, even though the door was sudden and they brought him out suddenly, he put his destiny on delay. And the reason why he put his destiny on delay is because he had some personal things that he needed to address before he went into his future. I wish I had 6 people up in here that would talk back to your preacher. Some of you, your destiny is ready, but it's on delay because you need to address some hindrance in your life. Y'all quiet up in here. Tell somebody, stop delaying your destiny. So what happened here? How do we look at this? What do we see? The first thing that he did was shave himself. They tried to get me a beard, but the beard wouldn't act right, so I'm going to have to. Y'all just got to get you an imagination up in here. Tell somebody, shave yourself. I need you to really holler, shave yourself. Watch this, because the beard represents one's identity and one's mentality. In other words, an Egyptian beard means that you are in a hopeless spirit. An Egyptian beard means that you've got a victim identity. You are a slave and you have a slave identity. You have a depressed identity. You have a bondage identity. And Joseph shaved himself because even though he was in a new season, he was looking like what he had been through. Am I helping three people up in here? He shaved because he recognized I still look like my past. I still look like my disappointment. I still look like my frustration. Sometimes, my brothers and sisters, opportunities of new relationships, new jobs, new friendships, new marriages are short-lived because we still look like and act like what we've been through. This thing says I got 18 more minutes. Watch this. We look like what we've been through. Please hear what I'm saying. And yes, you say that I'm waiting on God to change me. I'm waiting on my counselor to change me. I'm waiting on a new experience to change me. You keep saying I'm waiting on that change. I know I got issues, but I'm waiting. But can I tell you what the Lord is telling me to tell you right now? God is telling me that this job is for you. God says when you are really ready to change, I've graced you with the strength and the power of your transformation. Y'all gonna sit on me like that? I must be prophesying real good. I must have said your address. I must have called your seven digits. Because God said, stop lying that you're waiting on me. He said, I'm waiting on you. I need you to get the razor and I need you to get in your own mirror and look at your own self and say, this is not who I'm called to be. Tell three people, shave yourself. Shave yourself. I feel like preaching here. Watch this, my brothers and sisters. God is saying, I'm giving you the razor of truth about your identity. I need you to shave your past off. I need you to shave that victim spirit off. I need you to stop looking unhealthy because you look neglected long enough. You look unhealthy long enough. You've been walking around with this victim identity long enough. Help me preach to somebody and say, it's time to shave. Tell them again, it's time to shave. Let me just go on in there. Stop requiring your friend to shave you. Stop requiring your husband to shave you. Stop requiring your wife to shave you. Stop requiring your pastors to shave you. Stop requiring your prayer warrior to shave you. Stop requiring your therapist to shave you. Stop requiring anybody else with your personal responsibility. It's time for you to get in the mirror and look at the features of your character and say to yourself, enough is enough. I don't need nobody to tell me this. I see it for myself. I don't need anybody to remind me. I can see it for myself. I don't like that thinking. I don't like that stinking thinking. I don't like that attitude. I don't like that lust spirit. And I'm tired of just praying about it. I'm ready for some change with it. Tell somebody, shave yourself. Look at this. Don't let your past distract your future. The worst thing that he can do is get in front of Pharaoh, and all Pharaoh can see is this beard. Y'all quiet up in here. Your issues is being destructive to what God says that should have been dealt with before you got at this level. Y'all quiet in this place. You have mourned long enough over your bad decisions, over your bad relationships, over your bad experiences. Now it's time to shave those situations off. You done cried about him, and you done cried about her long enough. Now it's time for you to shave them.
Oh, I see y'all ain't gonna give no money on that. I see y'all ain't gonna support that. Because y'all still rather be in mourning. Y'all still want your mourning clothes on. Y'all still rather be in grief, but the devil is a liar. Your destiny is calling you. Your destiny has unlocked the door. Your destiny is saying it's a new season. It's a new day. A fresh anointing has come your way. It's a season of power and prosperity. Tell somebody you in a new season. You in a new season. You in a new season. You have cried long enough over who betrayed you and who disappointed you. Now it's time to shave. Shave yourself. It's time to take ownership of what you need to do in order to change your life. Tell somebody one more time, shave yourself. For a season, you may have to get up every day and look in the mirror and remind yourself of the new you. You've got to come on, somebody. You may have to get in the mirror every day and say, that's old, and the old thing has passed away, and behold, all has become new. I am the head and not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. Come on, somebody. I say, get in the mirror and say, I'm royalty. I'm God's child. I'm victorious. I'm healed. I'm delivered. I'm set free. I am victorious. I'm wealthy. I'm prosperous. I'm the curse breaker. Tell somebody, I'm in my own mirror. I don't need a prophet. I don't need a soothsayer. I don't need a 9100 number. All I need is a mirror. I don't know about you, but in this season, I'm shaving off haters. I'm shaving off lies. I'm shaving off backstabbers. I'm shaving off my shame. I'm shaving off discouragement. I'm shaving off betrayal. I'm shaving off disappointment. I'm telling God, thank you for letting me be myself again. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to come out of yesterday. I'm ready to come out of Lolaborn. I'm ready to come out of the valley. I'm ready to come out of prison. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard what God has in store for me. Tell somebody, I'm coming out of this in the name of Jesus. And if you're really coming out, I need you to get some victory praise in your hand and give them glory. I just saw something that ain't me no more. I just heard something that ain't me no more. I just got a call that ain't me no more. It's a new day. Now listen to me. And I've got to move on. I got to close. Now I hear some of y'all saying, well, Brother Preacher, please understand. I've already shaved. I shaved 15 years ago. I shaved 40 years ago. And my answer to your shaving is, why is it that everybody but you can see that long beard on your face? See, please let me explain something about beards and razors. That's a daily relationship. Yeah. Y'all ain't gonna talk. Y'all ain't gonna talk. Yeah. No, see, every day I have to get up. And after I wash my face, I have to grab Mr. Truth. Because overnight, don't know when it happened, don't know how it happened, didn't even feel it. Whiskers started coming, just came out of nowhere. I started feeling hair bumps, just came out of nowhere. And so before I talk to you, I gotta talk to myself. Before I relate to you, I got to relate to myself. Section C, y'all real quiet up in here. Before I deal with you, I got to deal with myself. Before I shave something off of your life. It's a daily relationship. I have to be committed to truth for myself before I require truth from you. I got to make sure that I walk in deliverance before I require you to be in deliverance. I got to make sure I'm walking in integrity. Y'all don't like this word, huh? Before I require you to be integrity. Tell somebody it's a personal relationship. Watch this. The Bible said he changed his clothes. I've got 7 minutes and I'm gone. He changed his clothes. And the next thing, no, the Bible said he shaved his beard. Then he changed his clothes. I said he shaved his beard. Then he shaved. Then he changed his clothes. I've got a question for all of you all living here. And about 20 of you all are going to catch this. And it's going to be an epiphany. And something is going to liberate in your spirit. You're going to get frustrated first, and then you're going to get liberated. I got a question for you. Here's my question. Who gave you those prison clothes that you got on right now? Right now. Right now. Because you don't go and decide you're going to put on prison clothes. Somebody, you gave them the power to put your life under arrest. Somebody, you gave them the power to change your norm. And now you're walking around with orange on. Who did you give the power to give you a life sentence? Y'all still ain't gonna talk to me up in here? I just want to know, who is it? Who did it to you? Was it a close friend? Was it an ex-spouse? Was it somebody that you was working for? Was it a church that you went to? Was it a sexual predator? I don't know who it is, but I've got a word from the court on high, and the Lord said that you have served your sentence long enough. Your parolement is now. You have served your sentence in full. Now it's time to take off your prison clothes. Y'all quiet up in here. Hit three people and tell them it's over, it's over, it's over. Tell them again, it's over, it's over. It's time to take off your prison clothes. Tell somebody, I can see change on you. I can see change on you. Now, what is the clothes? The clothes represents your values. It represents your values. It represents how you see things. And how you see things affects your character, your behavior, and your lifestyle. Please hear me, my brothers and sisters. There is nothing wrong with your gift. There's nothing wrong with your talent. Your business skills are second to none. The only problem with Joseph was his gift is wrapped up in prison clothes. His talent is wrapped up in prison clothes. And that's the problem with the church today. Before we deal with the clothes in our character. We're trying to go into ministry. We're trying to go into destiny. We're trying to be married. We're trying to be lovers. And when we go into it, we're creating a duplex. Or we're creating a paradox. Because you should be ministering to me, but because of the prison that you're still in, I'm forever ministering to you. You're confusing me because you're telling me I should be free, but when I get around you, you're still bound. You're telling me I should be liberated, but when I get around you, you're still struck. You're still chained. You're still bound. In the name of Jesus, I command you to stop your your public ministry, and say, God, whatever you need to do, I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm ready. I'ma stop blaming my wife. I'ma stop blaming my husband. I'ma stop blaming my church. I'ma stop blaming my mama. I'ma stop blaming my family. I'ma be like the old song. It's me. It's me. It's me, oh Lord. Standing in the need of prayer. Not my brother, not my sister, but it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. Tell somebody, take it off, take it off, take it off, take it off. I done prayed long enough. I done been in the prayer line long enough. I've been counseled long enough. Ain't nothing else to talk about. Ain't nothing else to pray about it. It's time for you to make a decision to come out of your past. It's time for you to make a decision to come out of your hurts. It's time for you to make a decision to come out of your yesterday. It may not happen overnight, but little by little by little, I'm working with Jesus. I'm walking with Jesus. I'm talking with Jesus. I'm getting up in the morning and saying, Lord, save me. Lord, deliver me. Lord, do it in my life. I don't want to have deliverance. I don't want a partial victory. I don't want to have salvation. I want you to finish what you started in me. I don't want to keep talking about you working on me. No, I want to say it's done. I want to say it's finished. I want to say how I got over. Got over. My soul looks back and wonder how I made it over. Tell somebody this is the season of a complete work. Tell somebody you're not gonna walk around have delivered. You're not walking around have made whole. I'm coming out. Every day I'm making a decision for a change in my life. Every day I ain't taking that phone call no more. I ain't wrestling with that spirit no more. I'm getting in the mirror and I'm looking at myself and I'm saying a wonderful change has come over me. He's changed my life and now I'm free. Tell somebody, change look good on you. Tell somebody, change looks good on you. I'm free from your hurt. I'm free from that divorce. I'm free from that shame. I'm free from that disappointment. But the Bible said he didn't just take off his prison clothes. It said he changed his garments. I said he didn't just change out of the prison. He changed his garment. You can have that. Give it back to whoever had it. Tell him this is yours. I don't need it no more. I don't need your love no more. I don't need your affirmation no more. I don't need your encouragement no more. I got in the mirror and I encouraged myself. The last time I saw somebody encourage themselves was David. David began to encourage himself. Hit five people and say, encourage yourself. Encourage yourself. Encourage yourself. Look like royalty. This is my season to look like victory. This is my season to look like I'm the head and not the tail. To look like I'm above and not beneath. I don't know about you, but I'm looking at my past and I'm saying, I'm saying goodbye to yesterday. The song said it's too hard to say goodbye to yesterday. It ain't hard for me, because the reason why I used to look in the mirror and all I saw was my past. But now when I look in the mirror, all I see is my future. Tell somebody you're somewhere in the future and you look much better than you look right now. I need everybody to jump on your feet. I'm finished here. And the Bible said, and he shaved and he changed his clothes. Now I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm saying goodbye. My door is open. My season is ready. Pharaoh is calling me. I got myself together. Goodbye. If I don't see you no more, you can stay in this prison, but goodbye. You can get stuck in your past, but goodbye. You can keep crying over yesterday, but my future is pulling me to a higher place. I need you to do me a favor. Turn around and look behind you. Turn around and look behind you. I begin to wave at it. Wave at your past and say goodbye. 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 I've cried my last tear. I've cried my last sorrow. Goodbye to all yesterday. Old things have passed away. And behold, all has become new. Now turn around. Look at the front. Turn around. Look at the head and begin to wave. Wave at your future. Wave at your destiny. Wave at your new beginning. I'm not living there anymore. I'm in a new season. I'm not there anymore. I'm walking a new walk. I'm talking a new talk. I am I'm in a new place. I've moved out of my old house. I moved out of my old place. Tell somebody, I see you in the future, and you look better than you look right now. Can you clap and thank him that you're in your promotion? Thank him you're walking in your destiny. Thank him for a new season. Give him a praise. We're getting ready to go home, but I feel about 10 people need to come down to this altar and just start walking, walking in your spirit and say, listen, this is my new season. I just need some people to come walking and say, I'm moving around. I'm moving around. The waters is troubled. Things are stirred. I've been here long enough. I've been wandering long enough. I've been crying long enough. Just start walking. Get ready for a new day. Get ready for a new season. Get ready for your steps to be ordered by the Lord. I got to stop here. It's time to go home. I got to go see a friend in the hospital. But I feel like preaching right now. God is saying, you got your razor. God is saying, you got your assignment. God is saying, it's your new day. I need you to take off those grave clothes. Take off the spirit of heaviness and put on a garment of praise. I de-double-dare you for the next 30 seconds. Lift up your voice and give him a praise. It's a victory praise. It's a victory praise. Walk it out. Walk it out.
Jesus meet you.
and I'm shaving myself. In your belly, you have arrived. You have arrived to your liberation. You have arrived to your renewed strength. You have arrived to your clarity. You have arrived to your victory. Let that baby come on across here. Come on. He running right now, but the oil is in his life. We're getting ready to go. Is there anybody that says, Bishop, I want to be saved. I want to be restored with God. I want to join this church. I want you to raise your hand right now. I want you to raise your hand right now. It's time to come out of your past. It's time now to come out of your past. Tell somebody, come out of your past. If that's you, I want you to wave real high because I need to see this, these lights of what it is. Hallelujah. Is that your hand, sweetie? Can you come on up to me right quick? Come on up to me. Come on up to me. come on up to me. Y'all see all these young folks coming? There's about six more of you all. There's about six more of you all. Stay right here. That you say, I'm ready for rededication. I'm ready for my new season. Come on up. Come on up. Come on up. Come on. The devil is mad because this word gave some people some razors today. This word is going to have a change clothes ministry, and they're coming out. There's three more of you that need to come right now. This is your Ina Sohoko Mataya. This is your season of a new beginning. You're ready for your new day. Hit three people and tell them, I'm ready for my new day. I'm ready for my new day. I'm ready. I'm ready. I've been in this past long enough. I've been in this past long enough. All right, I'm getting ready to dismiss. But I feel something in the spirit of this house. There's a deeper level of deliverance in this house. There's a deeper level of breakthrough in this house. God says, if you will move from spectator and release yourself in my presence, release yourself in a praise, I'm going to give you that freedom. I'm going to break that depression off of you. This is not what you're called to. Who put those prison clothes on you? We're taking it back off today. We've served this sentence long enough. Tell somebody it's a new day. Now, Father God, I thank you right now for what you've done in this service. We receive what you have said and what you declared. I thank you right now for the Amoshataya, for a turn in our lives. We're no longer comfortable with prison lifestyle. We're no longer satisfied in a prison and in a dungeon made by man. My destiny is breaking me out. My anointing is breaking me out. My dreams is breaking me out. My blessings is breaking me out. I'm leaving out of this place, breaking out little by little. I'm leaving out of this place with no more shackles on my mind, no more shackles on my spirit. I thank you that I'm renewed in my strength, and I'm coming out in Jesus' name. All week long, healing, favor, blessings, open doors, new beginning, new seasons upon your people life. I decree it, and I declare it in Jesus' name. And the people of God shout, hallelujah! 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 And amen. Now listen, those of y'all that came up, ushers just take them right on over. Right on over there, and they're going to get you the information. I want one of the ministers to go, Sister Lenore, go over there, and I want you to pray with them one more time for whatever they need. Can you clap and thank God for what he's doing in their life? I said, can you clap and give God praise for what he's doing in their lives? I've let you go, but as we're going, I'm singing this for every mountain. You brought me over. For every trial, you've seen. I'm gonna go home shouting on that. Listen, if you wanna work with the anniversary team, they're gonna be in the cafe. Take pictures with somebody. This is International Sunday. Take pictures with somebody. But more than anything, take a good look at yourself, because something new is happening to you. Tell somebody something new is happening to you. Something new is happening to you. Hey, hey, hey!